All right, y'all. I think I'm back live. Okay, here we go. So give me a second. I'm gonna try to. I think I'm back live. Let me make sure. Let me look. I'm trying to look and see. Hope I'm back live. So I'm gonna crank this up for a second just to try to let y'all get back in here.
And I don't want to hear it from a human. You made it, so you're the last person that I'm ever gonna ask. Tell me what's real, tell me what's fake. Why is everything about you a debate? What's the point of love? Every time I showed it, I was broken, and it's forced me just to only want to hate. Why is it only one you but multiple religions? Why does every conversation end in a division? Why does everybody want to tell us how to live, but they won't listen to the same damn message that they give it? Tell me how to feel, tell me what's wrong. I tried to call, pick up the phone, I'm on my own. Everybody says you coming back to man, why the hell's it taking so long? Why do I hurt? Why is there pain? Why does everything good always have to change? Why does everybody try to profit off another man's work then destroy it just for monetary gain? Tell me, are you black or are you white? I don't even really care, I just really want to know what's right. They've been saying one thing, but I've been looking in the book, and it seems like they've been lying for my whole damn life. Tell me where I'm going. Is it heaven or hell? I just hope this message greets you well. Had a dream that I was walking with the devil. Don't remember how it feels, but I swear that I remember the smell. Looked me right into my eye and told me everything I wanted could be mine if I gave up and decided to sell. But I said I'd rather die than get mine. Now I'm here, no fear, one man with a story to tell. Dear God, where were you when I needed it? When I fucked up and repeated it? When they set the bar and I exceeded it? My life is like a book that they've been judging by a cover, but I've never took the time to fucking read the shit. I remember telling you my goals and my dreams, but you didn't even answer, so I guess you didn't believe in it. I remember sitting with a gun to my head trying to ask you for some help, but I get you to believe it. I don't want religion, I need that spirituality. I don't want a church, I need people to call a family. I don't want to tell my sins to another sinner just because he's got a robe and he went to some academy. I don't want to read it in the book, I want to hear it from you. Don't want to learn it in my school because they hiding the truth. Don't want to talk about it to another fucking human being, and that's the only reason that I even step in this booth. Dear God, how do I take this darkness and turn it into light? How do I believe in a concept where I speak to a man I've never seen with my own two eyes? How do I know that religion wasn't made just to separate the world and create a whole disguise just to keep us in these chains while the rich get richer and the poor pray to you and perpetuate a lie? How do I know this ain't some big joke? How can I have faith when there is no hope? How the hell does one man have $100 billion and we still have people on the street that are broke? There's a lot of things I want to talk about and get off my chest. I can't sleep because the devil won't let me rest. I used to know a fucking pastor in a church and I can still hear the screams of the kids he will fucking molest. Dear God! I'm supposed to fear you, but you ain't said shit, so maybe it's you who actually fears me. I don't know the answer, I just want to see it clearly. So many lies and 1,000 different theories. All I want to know is who really made religion, because I know it wasn't you, but don't nobody believe me. No more lies, no more death. Bring back King, bring back X. Please, dear God, let their souls rest. Protect who's left and watch their steps. Dear God, I don't want to have to ask you again. I just hope that you know that I'm still a believer, so I'll end this all by saying amen.
Can you guys please do me a favor? Any of you that's coming in, can you please share this live to the groups or whatever that we're in? I can't share. I'm in Facebook jail, so and this is my backup page, so I'm not in a lot of groups on this page. So if you're in any good groups who this will make sense to, post in this group. Can you please share it to those groups? Can you invite some of the people you know, maybe in religion and that follow religions to this group, to this live? I'm getting ready to go back in where I was at. But as I was saying, there's a live going on tonight on the podcast, Sin City Untamed Podcast, tonight with myself, Kevin Wesley, the sister from Sin City. We have a Christian. There's a Luciferian. There's a Hebrew Israelite. All of us will be on the panel tonight. And I know I'm not going to have a chance to really go in like I'm going in now. You feel what I'm saying? Or like I just went in on part one of this. So for those people who are new to me and don't know where I stand on things and why I stand on them, they'll get a better understanding. Well, maybe going to my YouTube page, which is Truth Speaks with Chief Cali on YouTube, or either coming to my pages on Facebook and seeing these lives. But right now, I'm gonna let you while I try to get this shared to some of the people that were just in here. I'm gonna play this. A lot of people ask me about prayer. I'm gonna walk you into why I don't believe in prayer. So give me one second. What is this? A lot of people always talk to me and wonder. I'm trying to get it to come up. Let me see. They ask me about prayer, and there's a lot of different reasons I don't believe in prayer, but I'm going to try to play this and maybe give you a better understanding. And give you a better understanding of where I stand at. That's what I was kind of going into before I ended the last live. So check this out, and I'll be back in just a second.
I mean, we're dealing with prayer.
I get asked a lot about prayer. My coworkers ask me about prayer. Once people find out I no longer believe in religion, I get asked about prayer. So you might see different videos of me speaking on prayer, because there's a lot of different examples I can show, I can bring to the table of what makes me no longer believe in prayer. My reasonings. So sometimes just different things I may run into on a daily, or different things someone may be telling me may lead me to another video of why I don't believe in prayer. So a lot of people know since July 4th, 2016, I have been doing a worldwide prayer challenge for any believer who wants to pray with me. Go live, do a live broadcast so we can pray in front of the world. I've been wanting to do a live broadcast with any believer of any faith, of any religion, any of them, with any God they want to bring to the table, any of them, not just Christianity. But I've been doing this challenge since 2016. I'm sorry. The challenge just started last year, 2019. July 4th, 2019, I've been doing this challenge, this prayer challenge. I can't get any believers that want to come on and pray with me. The couple believers that I did get to come on and pray with me were just everyday normal people who didn't know what they were walking into when they came on the prayer challenge. One of the sisters that came on, she did the prayer challenge with me. I made a lot of sense to her. She no longer believes in prayer. The other brother that did come on and he prayed with me, he knew what the challenge was. He knew what my challenge was. He knew what it was about, but his pride wouldn't let him say, yeah. He went ahead and prayed with me live on a broadcast, which you will find on my YouTube channel. He prayed for world peace. We still have a messed up world. Actually, the day me and this brother prayed, the day me and him prayed, Trump bombed Iran after he prayed. He prayed for sickness, the end to all sickness. People are still in hospitals. People are still sick. People are still hurting in pain after he prayed. He prayed for the sex trafficking that's going on, just at least here in Atlanta. Let's start here. He prayed for that. Sex trafficking is still going on here in Atlanta. So me as a non-believer, he didn't win me over on the prayer tip. I didn't see where prayer worked. But he made sure to let me know how his how this God showed up for his father's prayer when his father was going through something, some medical situation. But he had four bypass surgeries or something. He also had his legs amputated, all of this. He made sure to tell me his father survived all of this. And and this is why prayer works. But he couldn't explain to me the difference between cause and effect and God's miracle. Because a lot of what he was telling me sounded like cause and effect. Doctors, hospitals, surgeries. You get what I'm saying? I couldn't distinguish cause and effect versus God's miracle. Once I brought this to his attention, it made a lot of sense to him what I was saying. He said, that's a good question. This is all I try to do is get people to help me understand certain things, and I try to help you understand why I think certain ways about certain things. Also, I just wanted to show him, after all of this praying we did, I respectfully bow my head, and the world is still messed up. So then you'll have other people tell me I don't understand how prayer works and all of this. Listen, I'm trying all the avenues. I hear you're not supposed to pray out loud. I know people that done went in their war closets and pray, like the Bible says, to not pray on the streets, not pray in the synagogues. You go quiet. You pray quiet. Like I've gone through all the avenues, and I'm not seeing the results. All I'm seeing, all I'm hearing is personal prayer results. That's all I'm hearing. So let me go into an example, right? Let's go into an example. This just happened the other night. I'm sitting with a believer. I'm sitting with this young lady. And she's telling me her young cousin, and when I say this lady is a believer, this lady's a believer. She loves her God. She loves her Jesus. She believes in all of this, right? So I'm sitting with this young lady this night, and she's telling me her story. My cousin's in a coma. She's worried. She's hurting. You can see it. And she's telling me how her cousin's in a coma. And then she goes on to tell me that, I hope God is going to bring her out but then she went on to tell me that the family have been getting together and they have prayed, going hard, praying, right? Then she tells me her cousin has gotten worse after the praying. Now me as a non-believer, this isn't adding up to me. This isn't adding up to me. So I'm looking at all the Bible verses. If anything you ask in my name, I shall do it. God would do anything if you ask, if you believe it. Like everyone that asketh, receive it. If you abide in me, all of these Bible verses. Because this is the religion she follows. So all of these Bible verses are popping up. You abide in me, I abide in you. You have not because you ask not. And so I'm sitting here listening to this, right? And I'm hurting for this woman because I know how much she believes in this God. And I know how much she believes in prayer. And I'm hurting for this woman, right? Because I'm like, gosh, what are you doing, Jesus? Like, what? So I kind of want to say to her, like, I really just want to say to her, this is what's in my mind I want to say to her, right? In my head, this is just what I want to say to her. I want to say, hey, you're a real believer. I know God knows you love him and you worship him. I see you do it every day. I see you do it all the time, sis. You can't pray to Jesus and ask Jesus to open their eyes, your cousin's eyes, out of coma. Jesus won't do that for you. Jesus, as much as you worship Jesus, Jesus won't do that for you, sis. Like, what do you have to do, sis? Like, this is what I want to say to her. Sis, like, why is Jesus not opening your cousin's eyes when you pray? When you and the family pray, how did your cousin get worse, sis? Worse? I don't understand, sis. Like, how does a believer like you cry out to your God and cry out to this Jesus, right? And your cousin gets worse? But being the person I am, I have a heart, man. I have a good heart, and it really hurt me to watch this woman in pain about her young cousin. And as I'm listening to her, I have to find ways to comfort her. I have to find ways to comfort her because Jesus is failing, and because God is not answering this woman's prayers, this believer's prayers. So I have to make up for this. I have to do this. I have to. I mean, why do I have to comfort one of Jesus' believers? Why do I have to comfort her, right? Why do I have to find all the words to make her feel better? Or why me? Like, this is one of your beliefs. This is what I'm thinking. Like, this is what I'm thinking in my head. Like, gosh, I know this woman loves her Jesus. I know she loves her God, her Christianity. I know she is a faithful worshiper from every day I see her, right? Then I start thinking. I say, God, like, what kind of God are you? What kind of God? Because then I started thinking, the Super Bowl just passed. Right? The Super Bowl just passed. Two teams, I'm sure, prayed that they would win the Super Bowl. One of those teams' prayers got answered, that they would win a game. A meaningless game. Also, people gambled on that game. A lot of people had a lot of money put up on that game. People prayed that they would win that game, so they would win that money. And they will tell you their prayers are answered. Their God answered their prayers. That's how they won the Super Bowl. And that's how the people that gambled won their money, because God answered their prayers. So now I say, wow, damn. What kind of God are we dealing with here? It was seen that God's priorities are very messed up to me in my eyes. It doesn't make sense to me. So pray for what? Somebody prayed that they would win a Super Bowl, and they did. Somebody prayed, let's just say this, somebody prayed who doesn't even really, really believe in God or like that. Damn near, might as well be a non-believer themselves. Prayed that their team would win the Super Bowl so they could win a bunch of money. And they would tell you they won that bunch of money because God, they prayed to God and God answered their prayers. Somebody who believes in this God wholeheartedly, fears this God, doesn't want to disappoint this God, loves this God, prayed that their family member would get better in a medical situation. Prayed that God would touch their family member who just lost a limb and would make a miracle happen and grow this person's limb back. Let this person wake up out of their sleep with their limb back. And we can all, and they wanted to, so they could shout the miracle that God did through prayer. And this God ignored them. This God ignored their prayers, but made sure the non-believer who believed in the Kansas City Chiefs to win the Super Bowl so they could win some money won the Super Bowl. You have to make this make sense to me. So, do I pray?
So, once again, we got the live going on tonight, 11 p.m. tonight, Eastern Standard Time. It's going on that late because the live is coming from the West Coast. So that's why they'll be starting at 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time over there. Now, what I'm doing is I'm picking back up from part one where I'm telling you why I don't believe. I won't have time to really go in like I'm going in right now tonight on the live. So I know some of you are used to watching me go in and really grilling these believers. I won't be able to do that. I'm on somebody else's platform tonight. So I have to respectfully pull back. I'm not going to be able to, how I'm about to show you how I normally do these believers, the ones that get aggressive with me and want to bring their God to me, I won't be able to do that tonight. So this is just me showing people who are new to me why I believe the way I believe, or I don't believe the way I believe. You feel what I'm saying? So this is what you will not probably see tonight. You probably won't see this tonight because I'm on someone else's platform. But this right here, it's how I deal with energy. However the energy is brought to me, that's the way I deal with the energy. So this is how the energy is normally brought to me. And a lot of you who know me, y'all witness this. Y'all witness believers come to my page or come on my platforms and try to force their God down my throat. And it turns out like this a lot of times. World, shit's not working. Shit's been fucked up. This is the thing, bro. This is the thing. This world has been fucked up for the longest. Forever, bro. Forever. People have been praying forever, bro. And you mean to tell me this God ain't hearing none of this? This God ain't stopping none of this, bro? You mean to tell me this? Is this what you're going to sit here and tell me?
Listen, bro.
He's gonna. When is he gonna?
He's done it through believers in Christ, man. A lot of the improvements that have come in the world came at the expense of Christianity. And you can't deny that. Bro. That's what I was trying to tell you from the get-go.
Listen,
but you don't want to believe it because you have this arbitrary view of Christianity, of the Bible. And that's why you always on YouTube ranting and raving about this and that. But you don't even have a working understanding of Christianity, what it's all about, what it's done in history, or any of that.
Bruh, fuck all that. Fuck all that. Bruh, listen. Hold on, bruh. Now, you just told me to pray to this God, you have to pray in a, what? How you say it? We're going to get this right. Pray in a what way? A humble way.
And you're asking God
for something in a humble way, right? You don't think people have been asking God for shit since the beginning of fucking time in a humble way? You don't think
this shit? Name something.
Bruh, you think we the only people that's ever prayed for world peace? You think we the only people that's ever prayed for sickness and people to get over sickness? Bruh. People go to, listen. When y'all go to the hospital, bro, right? When y'all go to the hospital, right? And sister such and so is in a coma. And y'all send all them prayer warriors down there to ask this God in a humble way to pray over sister such and such to bring her out of that coma. We're going to send all the prayer warriors down there and we're going to pray and get sister such and such up out of that coma, right? Y'all are expecting results, right? Or no? Or are we not? We're going to ask this God all of this as humble as possible. Are we expecting results or not? We are expecting Sister Such and Such to open her eyes up out that coma, right?
Basically, in that situation, we leave it in God's hands.
Okay, so Sister Such and Such dies. Now what?
Okay, if she lives, then what? If she comes out of the coma, then what?
If she comes out of a coma, she's in a hospital, right? Which means they're probably working on her, right? They're probably trying to get her together, right? Hold on.
Now you're trying to switch up. No. I ain't got time for
No.
Like you. Stop. If she comes out of the coma.
Okay.
If the doctors already expecting her to come out of the coma.
So it's God if she comes out of the coma. It ain't God if she died of.
Huh?
It's God if she comes out of the coma, but it ain't God if she died.
I'm not saying that. I'm asking you, if she comes out of the coma, despite the expectations by the doctors, then who did it? Did God do it then?
I can't say God did it, but you will say God did it, right?
Nah, you can say it. No. God didn't do it. Hold on, bro. But if she dies, God is up there and he answered prayer.
Let me ask you this. Go ahead, man. So will we say God did it? Will we say God did that?
Either way.
Yes or no.
Will we say that
if she woke up, all of y'all prayer warriors are down there and y'all prayed and it's God, and you pray, hey, God, wake Sister Such and Such. Only you can do it, God. We believe in you, Father. And you wake her up out of this coma, right? And she opens them fucking eyes, bro. Are we going to credit God with that?
Who else are we going to credit?
That's not the question. I asked you, do we credit God? Yes or no?
Of course. Well, what?
Okay, let's stop. So we're
going
to credit God, right? So now, so that means this isn't just coincidence that this happened, right? Because this was God. This was prayer, and this was God, right? Correct? Am I correct?
Tone it down, man. What you yelling for?
That's just how I talk, bro. You follow me enough. Okay, you done seen right. me enough, so you know this how I talk. So, you're telling me...
Actually,
this
I'm
would,
not real for me.
Brother, listen. Would be God, right? This is what you're telling me, right? Yes. Correct. God. Prayer brought Mr. Such and Such up out of that coma, right? I want to make sure we got this understood, right? Yes?
I said it.
All right, now, follow me here. How do we prove that?
How do we prove it?
Yes, God. How do we prove that it was God? I get it.
You
pray.
You want empirical proof?
Let me show you something, bro. I'm going to come right back to that, right? Let me show you something, right? So I was in jail, right? Let me show you something. I was in jail, right? And the brother, we ain't 2 weeks, right? We didn't have a TV for 2 weeks. Kiosk was out and everything, right? So my homeboy, he a believer, right? So he said, you know, he like, man, I'ma pray we get this TV on. So I said, E, why don't you pray to God and make sure God, you know, see if God can cut this TV on for us, right? So 15 minutes later, right? The TV comes on. What the hell? Right? That's gotta be God, right? Would you say that was God? Because he said he was going to pray. And 15 minutes later, the TV came on, right? Was that God?
Well, that's a whole different scenario.
No, brother. Hold on. I'm taking you somewhere. Follow me. He asked for something from God. He asked for something from God, bro.
But that is a whole
Hold on,
bro. That's a whole different
I don't see how it is because y'all down there at the... You got believers praying for Sister Such and Such at the hospital. Then you got a believer in jail praying that he gets some TV. You feel what I'm saying? I don't see how it's different. God only answers certain type prayers.
It's not a matter of life and death. Like I don't know.
Oh, so all God only answers prayers of life and death? Do you know there was people in that church on their knees praying, didn't even know the killer was coming in there? You didn't think they were praying for world peace or praying for love in the world and shit? And God didn't even warn them that gunman was sitting in their church? No?
See, you done went to three other different topics.
Hey, bro, like, they all got to do with prayer. Whole,
God, let me answer. Because like I told you before, that we all had a mental capacity of doing right and doing wrong. That man came into church knowing what he was intended to do. So is that God's fault? Is it his fault?
Listen, I don't believe in God, so you can't ask me
God's
fault.
Okay, now you say, see, man.
Bro, I don't fucking believe in God, bro. Why do you keep asking me about God, nigga? Like, I don't fucking believe in God. I don't know what the fuck is God's fault. But according to y'all, it would be God's fault because he created the man who's going to do the evil. You don't fucking blame the fucking invention for breaking down if the inventor didn't create the fucking invention right. So you say that was that man's free will, right? So what about the people who came to church? Their free will was to come to church and worship this God, not get healed. That was their free will. They wanted to come worship their God. Their free will was taken to get killed. Do you think it was their free will to come to church and get fucking killed? Or do you think it was their free will to come to church and worship their God? Which one would make more sense to you? So this man gets to take away everybody else's free will because he's activating his free will. Jaylen! Is that how that works? The little girl that got raped in the church bathroom by the grown man, right? In Raleigh, North Carolina, 6-year-old girl got raped by a grown ass man, right? He was activating his free will to rape that little girl in the church bathroom, right? But what happened to that little girl's free will? You think that little girl her free will was, I want to come to church and get a grown man's dick in my pussy, in my child pussy? You think that was her free will, bro? Does that make sense? Let's talk about free will. Free will does not come with a reward or a consequence. Free will is fucking free will. I guess he hung up on me. I guess he hung up.
So that guy right there hung up on me.
Can y'all hear me? Can y'all hear me? The video had froze up. I don't know if I'm late getting back because the video froze on my end. So I don't even know if y'all saw. I don't even know how long I've been back, honestly. Yeah, that guy. Basically, he came in my inbox, coming at me with his God and what his God can do and how I'm misleading the people and all of this nonsense. He came in my inbox. That's the energy he got back. You get what I'm saying? Because I don't have time to play with you. If you're going to come in my inbox and tell me what this God can do and whoop-de-whoop-de-whoop, you get what I'm saying? But you can't back it up or you can't show me why this guy plays favoritism. You're going to get that type of energy back from me. So it was something else I was trying to show y'all, but I don't know if it's my internet acting up right now or if it's Jesus fucking with me or what the hell going on right now. But some of the shit I wanted to show y'all ain't happening. But I really wanted to show y'all the breakdown of how I break shit down. Like, you gotta make shit make sense to me. You gotta make shit make sense to me. If you gonna sell it to me, if you gonna scam our people in our community with this God shit and all of that shit, you gotta make that shit make sense to me. See, I'm not a part of the religious pep rally. I'm not them niggas. I'm not the ones who you can just tell whatever you want to tell at the religious. I don't know why this shit ain't. I'm not the it was something else I wanted to show y'all, but this shit ain't coming up. I guess we'll go to this lady right here. So this is what I want to do right now. And I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this right now. Yeah. What I'm about to do right now is actually a breakdown, right? I've only heard a little bit of this. So right now, I'm finna listen to this right now with you guys right here live, on the live. And I'm going to break. Can y'all hear me now? I'm back. Am I back? Okay. So we're going to go through this breakdown together, y'all and myself, right? Now this is called There's Power in Prayer. Your sound just went out again. Okay. So I'm calling this the breakdown show because I want you to understand when I hear believers talk to me, when they talk to me, I'm going to show you how I break down what they say to me. And this is where they have the problems with me, right? So let's listen to this.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another Transformation Tuesday. I have not done one of these in ages. I've been away for 2 months. I really do apologize. I'm so sorry for the lack of consistency, but I am back and I'm here to talk about the power of prayer and how us as Christians need to level up our faith.
So let me start here. She's already starting out telling me that there's power in prayer. This is what she's telling me. So now I'm listening to this. I'm listening to her talk to me as if she's trying to tell me about her God. She's trying to win me over to her God, to her religion. So first she starts out to tell me that there's power in prayer. That's what I hear. So when I hear power in prayer, now I need to know what type of power. Tell me more about this power. This is how I break shit down in my head when believers talk to me. Let's talk about this power. Tell me more about this power. So I'm assuming the power you're talking about comes from the God that you pray to. We're praying, right? So which means the power that you're about to tell me about comes from this deity that you want to sell to me to believe in. Let's carry on. Let's continue to break this down. Now, I chose this young lady because her video was only maybe 8 minutes or so. There's a pastor I wanted to break down, but his shit was like 30 minutes. But I wanted to jump into this. So she was short. She's a believer. She wants to tell me about her God. Let's see what else she's talking about. Right now, we know there's power in prayer. So she says.
When we are praying and making our prayer requests known unto God, we have low expectations of God sometimes. Sometimes we forget.
Yeah, this might take a minute. So everybody don't have low expectations when it comes to asking your God for things. Now, she said, God's prayer is them talking to God or whatever. She mentioned making prayer requests. So when you make a request, right, you are asking for something. You are asking for something if you make a request. I'm breaking this down how I hear believers talk to me. This is why this is called the Breakdown Show. This is why I don't believe. So you are requesting something from this God that you pray to, who you're telling me there's power in praying to this God. Now, I'm not part of a religious pep rally. This is hard for me to believe when I'm looking at the fucking world and people have been praying forever. You see what I'm saying about the math problem? Don't fucking add up. We're just starting with the first couple numbers and it's already not adding up. You're telling me there's power in prayer. People have been praying long before I was born. And the world is still messed up. Evil's still here. People are still being harmed. Sickness is here. What are they praying for? Where is the power at? Huh? Where is this power at? Is what I'm thinking at this point in her trying to sell her God to me and trying to sell to me about the power of prayer. Already your math problem isn't adding up. You're already requesting, you're asking this God. Now, there's going to be a lot of things that I heard so far that's going to come back to bite her in the ass. Walk with me. Walk through this breakdown with
the God that we serve. Sometimes we forget that this God reigns in victory, that this God is in the highest position of power and authority, that all strength and everything established on earth comes from him. So when we are praying, why is it that we doubt God? Why is it that we ask God for the bare minimum? Why is it that we limit what we ask God for because we don't believe that he will deliver, or we're fearful that he will deliver? Because really and truly, the word of God says that anything is possible for God. Like, there is nothing that is impossible for God. For man, things are impossible, but for God, God that rules in heaven, God that, you know, sits on the throne in heaven, that has a bird's eye view of everything, he is able to do anything.
Hold up. Let me stop her right now, because she going in, right? She going in. Sounds good, right? Sounds great. Sounds fucking great to the religious pep rally people, to the people who aren't going to challenge you on what you're saying. Sounds fucking hell yeah, God. Hell yeah, God. You can't nobody do nothing with you, God. You're the top man. No, nothing is impossible for you, God. Sounds good, right? Shit she's saying sounds great, right? Until you meet a nigga like me who challenges this shit, who tries to see if this math problem adds up, right? So I'm hearing you tell me, oh, this God is this and this God is that and nothing is. She says, why? She says, why do you doubt God? She says, why do you limit what you ask God for, right? Now, let me show y'all something. Damn. Let me see if I can pull this shit up. Let me show y'all something. I asked a pastor to pray with me. Let's go live, pastor, and pray for the world. I asked a pastor that. According to this lady, we shouldn't limit ourselves to what we ask God for. This pastor, none of these pastors would pray with me. None of these pastors will pray with me for the whole world. I asked these pastors, let's go live and let's pray for the whole entire world, that God will get rid of sickness, that God will get rid of evil. God will get rid of everything. I got more faith in your God. I'm giving your God the benefit of the doubt. You pastors, you believers, don't even believe this shit. You know how I know you don't believe this shit? Because we got a whole fucking pandemic going on right now, and y'all niggas ain't even in church. Y'all niggas don't have enough faith in your God, who you say has all the power, right? Y'all don't even have enough power in your prayer. Y'all don't even believe in your prayer enough to believe that being covered in the blood of Jesus, you can still go to church and don't have to walk around with no mask on. Y'all don't even have enough faith in your power of prayer that you pray to your God to believe that he would cure all of this up. You asked, you sent up prayer requests. Did none of you believers ask God to clear this shit up? No, you make excuses for your God. A believer told me this is gonna happen. This is gonna be like this until God gets ready for it to stop. What? So you're telling me your God is sitting with us. I told you, your God was right there when they were plotting this up. The virus is created. And I'm only just using the virus right now. I'm only just using the virus right now. Because see, all the shit y'all say ain't fucking adding up. This is why I don't believe. This is why people are waking up and walking away from religion. It's just like you telling your child to scratch their hands 10 times a day and there'll be $20 under their pillow every day. Eventually, when this child sees that that shit ain't working, that child is going to wake the fuck up and grow up out of that shit and be like, that shit don't work. That shit was a lie. That's exactly what's happening with religion and God and all of these deities and all that shit. That's exactly what's going on right now. The great fallaway that they wrote about in that book you believe in. This is just how I break shit down when you believers try to talk to me. Because see, this is the thing. I'm not debating no scriptures with you. We're going to talk reality. We're going to talk all of these claims that you guys have been making for years, since I was a kid, since before I was born, about your God. These claims have been made worldwide. Jesus is the biggest scam ever. Yep, I said it. And I made a video on YouTube called Jesus, the biggest scam ever. And I wasn't talking out the side of my neck. And I brought receipts in the video to back up my claims. You guys make all of these claims about this Jesus, this God, these allies, and all of these other Jehovah's and all these gods, y'all make all of these claims about these gods, but you can't back up none of it. None of it. Everything you talk about is from a belief system. That's why religion is called a belief. It's something you believe to be true. It does not make it true just because you believe it to be true. If I said there's four aliens standing right there outside that door right there, I can believe that to be true. Does it mean it's true? No, it doesn't. So yes, I made a video called Jesus, the biggest scam ever. It's on YouTube. Chief Cali presents Jesus, the biggest scam ever. And you will see, I bring receipts to show why Jesus is the biggest scam ever. This is why I'm a preacher's kid who don't believe this nonsense. Brainwashing our community, that's been brainwashing our community, that's been brainwashing the world worldwide in order to control the masses. Religion rules through fear. You're telling me all of this stuff. You're telling me you're asking this God for all of this stuff. This is what I'm saying. This God picks and chooses who he wants to help, who he wants to ignore, who he wants to listen to, who he wants to not listen to. This God always seems to show up for y'all personal, selfish prayers. Y'all personal, selfish prayer requests. But then when a nigga like me say, hey, I'm going to give your God the benefit of the doubt. Hey, pastor, why don't one of you pastors, any one of you pastors, any one of you believers who believe in your God, why don't any one of you do this prayer challenge with me and prove to this non-believer that prayer, everything you're saying, lady, everything you're saying right now in this video, prove to me and the rest of us that have questions about prayer, about God, prove to us that God really does make shit happen. I don't know what he fucking did for your personal shit. That's your personal shit. That's your personal shit. I don't fucking know what he did in your, I wasn't there to witness that shit, to vouch for that shit. That's your personal shit. So this is why I don't believe. This God picks and chooses
who the fuck he wants to help and not help. Like, that shit's weird to me. That shit's weird to me, y'all. Y'all gotta make that shit make sense. Hold on, y'all. It's something I want to show y'all. And I'm gonna just have to go through YouTube to do this shit. I ain't never did this shit. So, hopefully I do it right. But I want y'all to see what the fuck I'm talking about. I want y'all to see how I break this shit down. I'm finna get back to her breakdown. Give me 1 second, y'all. Let me find this shit, though. Let me find this shit. I want y'all to see. I don't play with them. And I bring the same energy. However you bring that energy to me, that's how I'm gonna bring. Oh, man, please don't come with the godly energy, the arrogant godly energy to me. Please don't come with the arrogant godly energy to me. I want to show y'all something. I want to show y'all. I don't play, man. Like, I'm not finna debate no fucking scriptures with y'all. We gonna debate reality. We gonna debate reality. All the claims y'all make about your God, we gonna put that shit to the test. And we gonna see who's really the deceiver out here. I'm gonna make sure I got the right one. I want to make sure. I'm going to get right back to her. I'm finished breaking her down. I might not even go all the way through with breaking her down, because I think y'all get what I'm, how I work. You can't just tell me no shit. God, I just want y'all to see how I break shit down. Give me 1 second. Let me find this shit, because I want y'all to see how I work these niggas, man. And what I'm looking for, the video I'm looking for is on my YouTube page, Truth Speaks with Chief Cali. And that's where you'll find all my fucking videos where I be going the fuck in. I don't hold no punches. All right, I see part one. We might just rock. Okay. All right, so let me get back to the camera. All right. I ain't even finna go all the way in on her. I'm going to just break her down just a little bit more.
Let's the impossible. And God has really been showing me that there is power in prayer. When we speak to God, we're literally communicating with Him in the heavenly realm. One misconception about prayer is that God cannot hear. One misconception.
So, she says, this is what I'm saying. They make the claims. I heard a sister say, atheists run around here trying to prove that God doesn't exist. No, we don't. It's people like her who come up to us. It's people like your pastor who comes up to us. It's people like your pastor who sends his members out in the community to our houses and stuff. It's people like your pastor who sends his members out to the grocery stores and stuff to stop people to pray and force their God down our throats, which brings us out to say shit like, your God don't fucking exist, or your God ain't shit. That's how I talk. When you bring that shit to me. I don't know if y'all talk like that. It's just how I fucking talk. The thing is, you don't go through everyday life just believing shit because somebody told you to believe shit. You look for evidence, right? Why don't y'all look for evidence with these guys, with these claims they make? See me? I'm looking for evidence. You're going to make this claim to me? You just said to me, God can do anything. God's impossible. God hears everything and make your request to this God. Basically, you're telling me to ask this God. This is what another believer is telling me. She's not the only believer around the world who makes these claims about their God. It's all over TV. It's all over the news. It's all in your neighborhoods. It's all in your communities. It's all in your house. My mom and them make these same claims about their God. But none of them can back these claims up when they make them.
He is everything that you say. Just because it may not look like God is working doesn't mean that He's not working. You know, when we pray and we don't automatically see the changes that we are looking for, God is working behind the scenes. And another misconception about prayer is that.
Y'all hear the excuses? When you pray and you may not see the results right away, just believe that God is working behind the scenes. How do you know that? That's what I would ask. That's how I talk to them. How do you know what you just told me? How do I verify this, sister? This is how I talk to them. Where did you get that information from, sister? Who told you that? That's how I talk to them when I break them down. Okay, cool. I hear you. Sounds good. How do I verify that, sister? I mean, I want to believe what you're saying. I really do. Sounds good, right? But I can't just go around believing some shit you say just because you tell me to believe the shit. How do I verify that shit? Right, brother. Right. See, y'all, see how y'all are breaking this shit down too? This is, the brother said, didn't she just say God can do anything? That's how I break them down too. Wait a minute, hold on, it's more coming. It's more coming. That's why I say you have to listen. You have to listen to what they say to you. You have to listen to what they say to you. And I listen to every detail they tell me, and I say, didn't you just say such and such though? Or I say, how do I prove that? Or I say, where did you get that information from? How did you verify that? How do I verify that? This is the Breakdown Show. Callie Williams, the Breakdown Show. Let's keep going.
It has to be set that there's a certain way, there's, you know, a prayer guide to how you have to formulate your sentences, you know? When you talk to God, it's just a conversation. Like, I feel like we overcomplicate prayer. Prayer is literally just speaking to God, communicating.
I'll be forgetting. My bad. So what I was saying was, let's stop there, sister. Let's stop there, right? You just said prayer is just a conversation with God. I've heard believers say that shit, right? I've heard them say that shit. So let me correct you there, sister. That's not just a conversation, because not too long ago in the video, y'all see how y'all break this down? Y'all, I'm sure some of y'all are breaking this down. This is why this is called the Breakdown Show today. We're going to break this shit down. This is how I do when I... Peace, Phoenix. What's happening? How you go, sister? This is how I do when they speak to me. I ask them, wait a minute. How do you know that, sister? How do I verify what you just told me? Right? This is what I say to them. But, sister, you're on the Breakdown Show right now. So we're going to break down what the fuck you're saying. Now, not too long ago in the video, you just said you were sending up prayer requests, which means you were asking for something. You don't just make requests in a conversation. You get what I'm saying? When you request something, you are asking for something. Usually when you're asking for something, you will, or you are expecting results. So, this would no longer be a conversation, sister. This is no longer. A conversation would be, hey, God, how you doing? What's going on up there? Did you eat today? Oh, yeah, you seen what's going on down here? Yeah, man, it's crazy. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I just wanted to check in with you. This would be a conversation. But now, when you step into the whole thing of, hey, God, can you? Hey, God, will you? Hey, God, can you please? Hey, God, do this. We are now past a conversation. We are now asking for things. We are requesting results.
This is how I talk to them. This is how I break this down when they talk to me. When they bring their God to me, this is why I don't believe. Because if I'm asking this God, so this is what I'm saying. Do y'all think y'all are the only people on the planet who have asked for things from this God? This God picks and chooses who he wants to help, who he wants to ignore. But you'll make excuses and say things like she just said. When you don't see God working, or when you pray and you ask for things and you don't see God working, just know that he's working from behind the scenes. How do you know that, sister? Who told you that? Where did you get that from? Are you telling me something you know, or are you telling me something you believe? Because remember, religion comes from a belief system. It does not come from facts. So sister, how did you find that out? How did you find out that if I pray for something and I don't see it happening right away, just know that God is working behind the scenes? Hold on, let me break this down even a little more, sister. I'm gonna need you to pull up a Bible verse that tells me that. What verse in the Bible says that? Because in your book, the Bible says, God says not to, he says his word is pure. This God says his word is pure, and he says, you are not to add or take away from my word. So sister, I'm gonna need a Bible verse that backs up your claim. Then when you show me that Bible verse, there's more breakdown that comes with that. Because when you show me that Bible verse, let's just say it's there. Once you show me that Bible verse, now you gotta prove to me that a God really said that shit. How do we verify that? How do we verify that, sister? This is my breakdown. This is how Callie breaks down any believer talk to me. How do we verify that a God ever said that? Any Bible verse you pull out to me and you say to me, I'm going to ask you, who said that? How do you know that, sister? Where can we cross-reference that outside of your religious belief? This is how I break believers down. You can believe what you want to believe. I deal in facts. I deal in what I can see. I deal in proof. I deal in what's in my face. I'm going to ask you, this is why y'all don't like to talk to me. But let me show you what y'all do. Y'all use my passion. Y'all use my aggressive talk. Damn, we got an hour already. Oh. Y'all use the way I talk and how passionate I talk, and y'all try to use that against me and say, I don't want to go talk to him. Listen how he talks. He can't even hold a conversation, which is untrue. Because if you go on my YouTube page, you will see I've had conversations with three pastors on a radio show, and I didn't get like this. This is just me being who I am in the universe, on my page, on my platform, saying what I want to say. And a lot of times, this is how I respond to you that bring that energy to me and try to force your God down my throat. I reply like this. I reply nice and aggressively because I'm sick of the mental manipulation that was forced on us as kids. And y'all keep trying to force the shit on us and then get mad when we stand up and we fight against that shit and we say, yeah, we don't believe that shit no more. Then y'all want to cry victim. Oh, just listen, they're trying to force their belief on. This is what believers do. This is why I don't play with y'all. This is why I don't play with y'all. I give it to y'all just like this. Because y'all, if you're going to try to force it down my throat, I'm going to stand up and I'm going to look you face to face. And I'm going to be like, I don't believe that shit. Prove that shit, pastor. So they try to use my aggression. You hear what I'm saying? Never mind that I'm asking them to prove the Bible verse they just gave to me. Prove to me that a God ever said that shit. Never mind I said that. They'll go to the way I talk. My delivery is too aggressive. Never mind that I just asked you, how do you know that, sister? Where did you verify that at, sister? Never mind, I just asked that question. They'll go and they'll use, oh, he's loud. This is what I'm just telling y'all what the pastor said. I'm just telling y'all what the pastors say. Never mind that they stand in a motherfucking pulpit every Sunday and scream and yell and and tell you about your motherfucking life and what you're doing. Never mind that they talk aggressive all the time. Damn near every pastor I know, at least on the black side. But you try to use my aggressiveness when I challenge your shit. See, I'm not from the religious pep rally. You can't just say shit to me, and I'm not going to break that shit down. Hey, y'all, you have a fucking brain for a fucking reason. Why wouldn't you use that shit? Don't none of y'all ever, when they bring that God shit to you, when they bring that Yeshua shit to you, niggas think because you make God black, that makes him real. My nigga, what makes us cursed? Where did y'all get that shit from? Hold on. See, this is them Israelites. Here we go. I don't play with them niggas, right? Israelites. What the fuck makes y'all think y'all fucking, first of all, what would make you fucking think you're the chosen people of a God? First of all, where did you get that from? Stop. See, this is why it's called the breakdown. Chief Cali is going to show you how to break shit down if you don't know how to break shit down, my nigga. I don't give a fuck what Israelite you bring on my platform, what Christian you bring on my platform, Muslim, any of these guys. Bring any one of them. And I'm going to break this shit down just like this. Israelite, what makes you think you're God's? You would be a God's chosen people. Where did you get that from? You didn't come out the womb believing that shit, knowing that shit, right? Where did you get that from? Where did that come from? See how I move slow? I gotta break shit down slow. Let's figure out where that even came from. Oh, a book? Literature. Okay, cool. What would make us cursed? Who cursed us? Oh, this is the curse of Ham and woo-woo-woo. Who the fuck is Ham? Who is that? Who is Ham? Who the fuck is Ham? Who the fuck is Ham? Breakdown. Break the fuck down. Who the fuck is Ham? Ain't nobody. Abraham. Who is Abraham? Who the fuck is that? Who is Abraham? Breakdown. Yeah, Cali's breakdown. Yahweh said. Who Yahweh said? Who what? Who the fuck is Yahweh? Huh? How do you know what the fuck Yahweh said? Where did you get that from? Breakdown. Like a motherfucker. I don't have time to play with you. I don't have fucking time to play with you. Where did you get that shit from? Who told you that shit? Abraham, Yahweh, Sham, Ham, Shem. Who the fuck are these people you're talking to me about? Let's establish that shit first before we move into all the curse shit. Let's establish that shit first. I can't move any further. I can't believe a fucking Yahweh, Yeshua, anybody else, or Abraham or Shemham, anybody else, Moses, any of them motherfuckers. I can't believe they said any fucking thing if they never fucking existed. Who are these fucking people? How do we verify these people even fucking existed? Breakdown. This is how I break shit down. I don't fucking play with you. You bring that fucking book to me. You bring any of them fucking books to me. I'm going to let you bring it. And then I'm going to say, how do we verify that shit? How do we know that shit to be true? Why do you believe that? This is where they have the problem with me. Let's just hear a little bit more of what she's saying. Let's check in and see what a little bit more.
God. And yeah, like, God has really been showing me the power in prayer, and I don't actually know why I've been neglecting the weapon of prayer. You know, prayer is a weapon. Prayer has the power to move things in the spiritual realm. Prayer has the power to move mountains. Sometimes we are blinded to the power in the name of Jesus. And I've got this.
Are we listening to the power of prayer? I ain't making these claims. This is not me making these claims. This is somebody making the claim to me, right? This is somebody telling me about this power of prayer. I told y'all, this shit sounds good at the religious pep rally. That shit she's saying sounds fucking awesome. Fucking awesome. Prayer has the ability to move mountains, and prayer is, it's a weapon. What does this weapon do? How do we prove this weapon exists? Nobody has ever proven prayer to work supernaturally, ever in life, never. No religion, nobody has ever proven prayer to work supernaturally, which is the reason these pastors don't want to pray with me. That's the reason, because they know their God's going to leave them hanging, because they cannot prove that prayer has ever worked supernaturally. It's mental manipulation to trick yourself into feeling better about some shit. Nobody on this planet has ever been acknowledged for proving the existence of any God of any religion ever, which is why religion is a belief system. Nobody has ever on this planet been acknowledged for proving that prayer works supernaturally. Nobody ever. Which is why I don't believe in prayer. Which is why prayer falls under a belief system. You mentally trick yourself on purpose. All of this shit she's telling us, prayer this. See, this is how I break shit down. This is why they don't like to talk to me. Because this is how my mind works. I listen to everything you tell me. You're telling me prayer has the power to move mountains. What would this mountain be? I ain't seen prayer move a mountain. Who's ever seen prayer move a mountain? Oh, we're not supposed to take it literally? You know how that go. Am I taking it out of context? Is that what I'm doing right now? Who's ever seen prayer move a mountain? What mountain are you talking about? Are we talking figuratively or are we talking literally? I've never seen either. I've never seen prayer literally move any fucking mountain. Not saying it hasn't ever happened. If there's a God, I'm sure maybe it has. I'm just saying, I've never seen that shit. And nobody I know has ever seen somebody pray and literally watch a fucking mountain move. Figuratively, I've never seen anybody prove factually, yes, somebody prayed, and let's just say the mountain was, I don't know, to raise somebody from the fucking dead. I've never seen anybody come out the fucking grave after you prayed that your boy, you wished your boyfriend was here, or your daddy was here, or your, I've never seen nobody's mama, daddy, grandmama's, boyfriends, husbands, wives, kids, none of that shit raised up out the grave after prayer. And I don't know anybody who's ever seen that shit either. Not a pastor, not a deacon, not an usher, not a nobody. Why would I believe prayer has all this power that you tell me? I'm looking at reality. You're looking at belief. Sister, what you're saying right now is not coming from facts. It's coming from a belief. This is how I break shit down. This is the Breakdown Show. Welcome to Callie Williams' Breakdown Show today. This is for the people who want to know why I think the way I think, why I am a preacher's child, and I don't believe none of this shit that my parents preach, that any other parent, any of my cousins, aunties, uncles, and them believe in this stuff. None of that shit. Because what I see is me doing shit, other humans doing shit. I believe there's good, there's bad. You're either good or you're bad. Shit don't have shit to do with a religion.
shit to do with God or Jesus or Allah and Jehovah, none of that shit. Let's see what else you're talking about real quick. Breakdown, y'all. Let's
revelation.
Break shit down,
sometimes
y'all.
Sometimes I put life revelation to the power in my prayer life has changed. Jesus. In the beginning,
I've got this revelation,
God spoke
and ever since
life.
I put this revelation,
said,
my prayer life has changed. In the beginning,
and then we go to the New
God
Testament,
spoke
and
life.
Jesus
said,
is referred to.
Light.
Stop! I'm sorry, y'all. Y'all probably heard an echo and shit, but I ain't mute my mic. I be forgetting to mute my mic and shit. She said, in the beginning, God said, let there be light. God spoke. Sister, break down shit. How do you know that, sister? Who told you that? Where did you get that from? This is as easy as I break shit down. Sister, are you telling me something you know? Or are you telling me something you believe? It's okay if you're telling me something you believe. Then I know not to just take that shit as to be fact. But now, if you're trying to tell me this is fact, how do we verify that shit, sister? Why do you believe that? Why do you believe that with no evidence, sister? That's how I break them down. I do this shit.
As a light. So God literally spoke light. He spoke Jesus and darkness when it went. That's the power and authority that we have. That when we speak, because we are children of God, we inherit what our Father has. So when we speak with that authority. Sometimes I actually have to deep to myself, and when I'm praying, I will mention these things. Jesus will cast a demon out. He has authority to control and move things in the spiritual realm. And when we pray in the name of Jesus, we think that God will not hear us. We think that God will not change our circumstance. Can you actually deep the power that the God that we serve has? That God said, let there be light. And light was established, darkness went, and you think that you can go through a dark season.
Is what she's saying factual? I'm gonna ask y'all. I'm gonna ask you guys in the chat, is what she just said fact? Or is this belief? So, the name of Jesus runs demons away? Huh? How many of y'all heard that before? Is that fact? Is that a fact? These are questions I would ask her. After I ask her that, then I would start to show her things in reality. Evil things in reality. And I would say, well, sister, what happened with the demons that blew up that church? Okay, sister, so demons. You can say Jesus' name or you can shout Jesus' name and demons fear Jesus' name, and we still have evil here. We still have evil here, though. But all we had to do all this whole time was say the name of Jesus. Is that what you're telling me, sister? Breakdown. This is why I don't believe this shit. This is why I don't pray. Breakdown. This is Callie Williams. Breakdown show. Make it make sense to me. Why would I believe this shit you're saying with no evidence? Now I must ask, why do you believe this bullshit you're saying with no evidence? Is what she just said fact? It sounds good at the religious pep rally, right? Down at the religious pep rally where nobody's going to challenge the shit you're saying. Sounds good. So tonight, I think one of the questions on the show is, why are people walking away from religion and the church? It's because of shit like this. People are now asking questions. Hold on, y'all. I'm gonna get off her head. Let me see. I'm gonna try this, right? I never did this before. Let me see some. Let me try something. I want to try to take y'all. And this one, all y'all got to do is watch this one. I ain't even got to. I'm gonna show y'all the breakdown. I'm going to show y'all the fucking breakdown, how I break shit down. Let's see if I can get this up on the screen. I don't know how to do this, y'all, so give me a second. Okay, let's show on the screen. Let's get her off. Let's get that. We done with you, sister. We did a breakdown on you already. We did a breakdown on you, sister. I just had to use you as the first guinea pig for the breakdown. Now, let me see if I can get this brother on here. How do I look at this shit? Fuck,
How do I look at this shit? Hold on, y'all. I ain't never did this one right here before. Give me 1 second. Let me figure this shit out right quick, because I want y'all to see this shit. Okay, I think I know how to do it. Okay, this is, let me do it like this. I think I got to do it like this. Okay, give me 1 second, y'all. All right, let's see if this works. Let's see if this works, right? Let's try to bring this in. I ain't never did this, so maybe it works like this. Okay, I think I got it now. I think I got it, y'all. I think. Sharing this to okay, y'all, I think I got it now. Now, this right here, all y'all got to do is just watch this. I'm going to show y'all why they don't want to fuck with me, why they watch my videos, why these pastors watch my videos, and they make fucking videos about me, because, and why they won't play with me. I'm going to just let y'all watch this. I'm going to just let y'all watch this, and this is probably going to be my last video, because we already over an hour. So let me try to blow this up. I'm new to this one, y'all. Let me see, mute, audio only. Let me see how to do this. Maybe I need to do this.
The first point that I saw, point number one was God operates based on favoritism. He has a VIP list, you kept saying.
You know what I thought to myself when I watched part of your video at the farm in between working some horses, and I thought to myself, I said, you know what, if I was crazy, I'd think this guy's been to church before, right? In a sense, you're kind of right. Yes, but God does have a VIP list. I never really denied that or anything. I don't even feel like it's anything I need to concede. I feel like really we just agree on that point. First point that I saw, point number one was God operates based on favoritism. He has a VIP list, you kept saying. You know what I thought to myself when I watched part of your video at the farm in between working some horses, and I thought to myself, I said, you know what, if I was crazy, I'd think this guy's been to church before, right? In a sense, you're kind of right. Yes, but God does have a VIP list. I never really denied that or anything. I don't even feel like it's anything I need to concede. I feel like really we just agree on that point. Yes, God in a sense does have a VIP list, but I use that term very loosely. I'm only using that term because it's the term you used. Instead, if I had the preference, I would prefer to communicate it like this. God is a sovereign ruler and he can show grace to whom he wants to, but that he wants anyone who worships and believes him to be his people on the VIP list. So indeed, God does have a VIP list, and for the sake of preaching the gospel, anyone can be on that VIP list. Yes, Chief Callie, you can be on that VIP list. Anyone watching this video on your channel, on my channel, on YouTube, on the World Wide Web, on my Facebook, wherever, anyone can be on that VIP list, for Paul writes in Romans, anyone who believes in his heart and confesses with his mouth will be saved. So, I'll just, for the sake of argument, being saved is the VIP list. So if you want to be on the VIP list, you're welcome, man. I invite you personally. I invite you. Seriously, not being facetious or anything. That's just the way it works. So yeah, I don't really disagree entirely. Now, you know, there are some ways you could present the VIP list and change it and kind of manipulate the argument to then I would disagree with you. But in the sense that God does show a special favor as opposed to general favor, right? Even those who are not on the VIP list receive general favor, but God shows special favor to those who are on his VIP list. But then you brought some verses up. So you said, well, that doesn't make sense because Luke 11 says anyone who asks will receive. Well, you also said something else that really caught my attention. You said, I don't know how to, and I quote, I don't know how to interpret that any other way. I really appreciate the fact that you said that, because interpretation, the kind of the discipline of interpretation involves hermeneutics, right? So what you imply when you say, I don't know how to interpret that any other way, is that there's a right way to interpret and there's a wrong way to interpret. I agree with you. We agree on more things than I think you may be aware of right now.
So one of the things I wanted to bring up and I wanted to correct you on from your video is I did not say I could not interpret the, I didn't know any other way to interpret the scripture. That's not what I said. I said I didn't know any other way to interpret the word anyone and everything. And say I didn't know how to interpret the scripture. I said I didn't know any other way to interpret the word anyone and anything. So I just wanted to throw that out there because you misrepresented me on that in your hermeneutics segment part of the video. If you're on God's VIP list, this guy seems to have a VIP list. He plays favoritism on who he helps and who he doesn't help. So, I think that would be a problem when it comes to prayer. Especially when you see a verse in the Bible that says, everyone that asketh, receiveth. I don't know how to interpret that any other way when I see the word everyone. When I see anything you ask for in my name, it shall be given. I don't know how to interpret the word anything any other way than anything.
There's a right way to interpret and there's a wrong way to interpret. And just like you said, you just don't know any other way to interpret Luke chapter 11, right? That specific passage. Here's something I'm going to throw in this video, kind of a freebie, is this. You can take almost any verse, any couple verses, any passage out of scripture and make it mean whatever you want it to mean. You can present it in a manner where it just means whatever it is that you want it to mean. However, does that make it true though? Does that make it right? Right? Because I don't know you, but I know you well enough to know that don't make it right. Right? Since your statement assumes that there's a right way to interpret and there's a wrong way to interpret, because you're smart enough to understand that you can't just pick up some ancient document, take three sentences out, and just say, this seems like what it means, it must be what it means. Well, hermeneutics is a discipline. There's a way to interpret. So here's one hermeneutical tip that we are going to put into practice on this video so I can show you how Luke 11 actually does not contradict God's VIP list. Okay? The one hermeneutical tip I'm going to give you today is consider the text around your passage. Remember that I said you can almost take any verse and make it say what you want to say. So the way to avoid misinterpretation, the way to avoid poor exegesis is a word that's in the religious kind of study, if you will. So if you study religion, you would use the word exegesis. It means how to interpret. The way to avoid that is to consider the text around your passage. Consider what's below, consider what's above, what comes before it, what comes after it. And that's going to give you some literary context. It's going to give you an idea of what this person is talking about.
So one of the things I want to address is your human, how you say it, humanomics, or whatever you said, whatever the word was that you used yesterday about interpretation, right? So what I was saying to you in the other video was this. Brother, like, you can't hit me with nothing about no interpretation, right? Because you can't prove that the way you interpret this word is the one and only correct way to interpret this word. Just like you said in the beginning of the video, the reason why you didn't want to defend any other believer's words. Why? Because y'all all interpret this stuff how y'all want to interpret this stuff, bruh. So you trying to talk about the hermeneutics and all of this, and you know, and the way you interpret, how you interpret, and it's a good way and a bad way to interpret and all that, brother. You can't prove to me how to interpret anything if somebody else can say you're interpreting wrong. So all of you are interpreting stuff the wrong way or different ways. So how are you going to tell me how to interpret something if somebody else from another in your community can say, no, you're interpreting things wrong? But this is the thing. You and Pastor Wells and your little clique think y'all got the Bible interpreted the one and only correct right way. How do you prove that? Prove that you are correct in the way your hermonomics, Mr. Humanomics, prove the way, prove that you're interpreting this book the right way, these scriptures the right way. Because you're quick to tell me and other non-believers that we don't understand the scriptures and we don't understand how the scriptures work. We don't understand because we're non-believers. But yet and still, you have other believers worldwide who interpret that book the same way I interpreted it as a non-believer, and the same way I grew up in the church hearing that book interpreted by other preachers all around the world. Preachers who were here long, long before you and Pastor Wells ever touched the earth. Elders in the same community as you who interpret this book the same way. I even showed you other believers who interpret this book the same way. And I'm sure many of them use hermeneutics skills too. You feel what I'm saying? So y'all try to play this, oh, we're so brilliant in the mind, and you're not as brilliant as us, or you're not as smart as us, so we're trying to throw this intelligence game on you. Nah, nigga. No, listen. If somebody else from another sect of Christianity can tell you you're interpreting in the book wrong, then you can't tell me I'm interpreting things wrong. Because y'all got too much division going on about how y'all interpret this book. You feel what I'm saying? How y'all interpret these scriptures. Y'all won't even go to church with each other. Y'all won't even visit each other's church if y'all are not on the same page of interpretation. So you can't tell me, brother, about humanomics. You can't tell me. So you can miss me. That argument is out the window, brother. That argument is out the window. Because as long as somebody else can tell you you're interpreting wrong, you can't tell me I'm interpreting wrong. Especially if it's other believers worldwide. Worldwide. Who's interpreting this book, these scriptures, the same way me as a non-believer is interpreting. But of course, you and Pastor Wells and your little clique of ministers or preachers or whatever y'all are, y'all have the one and only correct way, right? Cool. Because I don't want no excuses for you not to get on God's VIP list, right? So I just wanted to say, other than that, we would throw your argument out the window. But for the sake of you getting on God's VIP list, you're right. I don't understand Mr. Humanomics. Because I want you to get on God's VIP list. I want you to be on God's VIP list. The religious pep rally, right? This is what I left off last video with. And I was telling you guys about the religious pep rally. What the religious pep rally is this. Believers are so used to talking to people, dealing with people who go right along with what they say. They're so used to dealing with people from the church. They're so used to speaking in the churches. They're so used to speaking in environments where there are other believers. Which is the reason Pastor Wells said to me, no, I will not pray with you because you do not believe.
I'm not praying with you. You don't believe, so what's the need for that?
See, he wants me to be a believer so you can be able to say anything you want to say to me. You get what I'm saying? And I'm just going to go along with it. I'm not going to challenge you. This is what they do in prayer. This is what they do in church, right? So when you walk into church, the pastor can get up there and say anything he wants to say. Nobody challenges the pastor.
Okay, I see food outside. Look at that. Look at that food. Be quiet. Be quiet. Okay, go and eat. Go and eat. Go eat outside. Go, quickly. it quickly.
Now that said, do me a favor, touch your neighbor and say F you. God, I wished I had. God, I wished I had 25 people that say, I forgive you for whatever you said about me. Not just your neighbor. Look down your whole row saying, F y'all too. Go ahead and tell them. You know what? Y'all looking at me crazy. Would you do me a favor? Take your phone out. Text all your exes and say, I'm at church. F you. Forgive you for lying on me and talking about me. Pastor, my mama don't like you. Well, F your mama. My family don't like you. F your family too. You know what? Jump on your feet. Snap your fingers. Say, F everybody in here.
Every brother, would you tap another brother and say, I should have listened to her. God help me. Old saints, y'all forgive me. But I got to tell you, these hoes ain't loyal. You got to find somebody.
So this is the religious pep rally. They want to be around people who won't challenge them, who won't challenge the claims they make about their religion, who won't challenge the claims they make about their God, who won't challenge the claims they make about their scriptures, who won't challenge the claims they make about the history of their religion, any of that, right? They don't want to talk to anybody who's going to challenge them. So when you go to church, you never hear nobody stand up and go against the pastor. Everything is amen, pastor, amen, pastor, amen, sister, amen, brother. This is what we call the religious pep rally. So when you're dealing with people who are believers, these are the people they really want to talk to. This is definitely the reason Pastor Wells said to me, no, I will not pray with you because you do not believe. What does it matter if I believe or not? You believe, don't you? It should not matter if I'm a believer or not. People pray with non-believers all the time. Make me a believer. You get what I'm saying? So, what I want Brother Travis to understand right now, because Pastor Wells already understands this, but what I want you to understand right now, Brother Travis, is you are not at the religious pep rally. You get challenged over here. You can't just say anything you want to say over here. Challenges go on over here. And you're going to get challenged in this video, sir. You are very well much about to get challenged in this video. You said a lot of things in that last video which would sound good. It would sound amazing at the religious pep rally. But you're talking to Kelly, and I'm not at the religious pep rally. You're not at the religious pep rally. Obviously, if you read the comments over here, you're not at the religious pep rally. You get what I'm saying? If we go over on your page and read the comments, all day it's the religious pep rally. You get what I'm saying? You're not at the religious pep rally. You're in the real world out here, where people actually can use their mind to think. People can actually use their common sense. People can actually use reason. People can actually ask questions. This isn't the religious pep rally where we don't ask questions. We just say amen. Because at the religious pep rally, y'all do things like this. Y'all say a lot of stuff that sounds good to say. It sounds great to say. Nobody's challenging you. Nobody's challenging what you say. Let's do a couple examples, right? Demons tremble at the name of Jesus. This is what y'all tell the people, right? Does that make it true because it sounds good to say? Does that make it good? Now, at the religious pep rally, it's going to sound great to say, right? But then when we look at the news, right, and we see a gunmen, bombers go into churches where people are shouting the name of Jesus, and they get gunned down while shouting the name of Jesus or while on their knees praying to this Jesus. Doesn't look like demons are trembling at all. It doesn't look like demons are scared of your God at all. See what I'm saying? But at the religious pep rally, this sounds good to say. Something else. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. Right? This is what sounds good to say when you're at the religious pep rally or you're talking to people from the religious pep rally. Other believers, right? They'll tell you this. Oh, it sounds so inspiring, right? Of course it does. Sounds like a great inspiring saying to say, right? As long as you don't bring it into the real world, where we put a good saying, a good sounding saying, up against reality. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. So what would weapons be? All types of things, right? You have weapons such as bills. You have weapons such as wars. You have weapons such as crime. You have weapons such as depression. You have weapons such as sickness. You have weapons such as mental illness, all type of illness, hurt, pain, suffering. You have hunger. You have weapons that come up against you. And they do prosper. So again, sounds good to say at the religious pep rally. You feel me, Travis? We ain't at the religious pep rally, brother. It sounds good to say at the religious pep rally. It sounds good to tell me this guy has a VIP list and I can be on this VIP list. It sounds good to say at the religious pep rally, brother. I ain't at the religious pep rally. And that didn't sound good to say to me at all. This guy has a VIP list. All right. We're going to get into that. But this is the religious pep rally. I just wanted Brother Travis to understand, you're going to get challenged over here. That's why your pastor didn't want none of that prayer challenge. Because see, I'm not for the dialogue. See, I'm not coming from Africa. I'm not giving you, oh, the Bible started in Africa and all of that. See, that's what y'all want. That's what y'all want. Y'all want to debate stuff like that. This is stuff y'all want. No. I'm bringing reality to the table. I'm bringing reality. Cali brings reality to the table. You get what I'm saying? I don't care nothing about your God in the past. If he existed, cool. Now, we got to find out where your God is now. And why your God ain't doing nothing. And why your God has a VIP list. You're right. This ain't the religious pet rap. This is the real world where you will get challenged. I live in the real world. I live in reality. You live in belief land. I don't. So, you want to make claims? We're going to talk about this VIP list. But first, let's figure out how we got to this prayer challenge.
So, that's how we got to, that's how we got to my prayer challenge that nobody wanted to be involved in. None of the believers wanted any parts of that prayer challenge. They wanted no parts of that prayer challenge because they knew their God was going to leave them hanging. They didn't even believe in their own God enough to believe that this God would do something for the world. He would show his miracle for the world. But they always will tell you God showed up for their personal, selfish prayer requests. Personal. Why does God always seem to show up and work miracles for people's personal prayer requests? This is why I say Jesus is the biggest scam ever. If you go on my YouTube page, you will find that video. It's called Jesus, the Biggest Scam Ever. You will see my reasoning. My reasoning for saying Jesus is the biggest scam ever. I know I'm not just talking out the side of my neck. I'm actually showing you why I say that because there are too many claims that you believers make about these gods and your Jesus, and it's not adding up like a math problem. It's not adding up. So this is for the people tonight who will see me on the live, and you probably won't get to see me go in like this because there's so many people going to be on the panel. And it's going to be so much I'm going to want to say, trust me. It's going to be so much, because it was last night when we did the test run. But I think we had four people. I think it's going to be six of us on the panel tonight. And it was four of us last night. And I wanted to. It was so much I wanted to say, but the sister was like, hey, save it for tomorrow. Woo, woo, woo. But I know tonight we're not going to. Because see, my questioning, there are steps to my questioning. One question leads to the next question, to the next question, to the next question. And I know I'm not going to have time to do all that tonight. So I'm going to get ready to get off of here, because these lives, I really didn't mean for these lives to be this long, man. But y'all know, like, it'd be so much that come to me. And y'all know a lot of this stuff, I don't take notes and stuff. I freestyle this stuff off the top of my head. Whatever come to me that I want to say to y'all, I bring it to the table. And a lot of times it takes us over into these long lives. So what I'll do is I'll chop these lives up. I'll take bits and pieces and I'll put them over on my YouTube channel. True Speaks with Chief Cali on YouTube. That's my YouTube channel. My main YouTube page, my main Facebook page is Cali Williams, except my last name is spelled with an apostrophe. W-I-L-L-I apostrophe M-S. That's my main page. It's in Facebook jail right now. I'll be there till May 26th. Yeah, May 26th, I believe. So this is my backup page. I found little loopholes to be able to, you know, still communicate with some of y'all on Facebook. Like, this is the only way I can actually talk to y'all is to go live. But then I found a way on my backup page, like, to inbox. I have to go to, I have to use another part of the messenger. I can't use the regular part of the messenger. Some of you know what I'm talking about because I've already talked to you through the other part of the messenger. So they'll probably be trying to figure that out now. But tonight, 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time will be the Sin City Untamed podcast show tonight. Myself and Kevin Wesley will be on the show tonight. And, you know, I think there's four other people that will be on there with talking about spirituality, religion, and why we believe, why we don't believe, things of that sort. So definitely come support us on there. I'm getting ready to get off of here. I'm probably in the next couple of days, I'll chop this live up and just take little pieces here and there. I kind of think I'm going to start doing the breakdown show. I think I'm going to start doing that. So if you guys see any testimonies, believers, if you're on YouTube or you're on Facebook and you see any testimonies these believers want to tell us about why they believe in their God and want to, you know, you want me to break the video down, send it to me. Let me listen to it. Let's see if we can get converted or something. Maybe it'll make sense. Maybe one of these testimonies will make sense. Because I'm not understanding how this guy does everything personally and is secretive. He never speaks for himself. He always speaks through somebody. You never see him. He always does his miracles in secret, you know. But then he wants to be worshipped. Then he wants to be prayed. I don't get that. Like, you know what I'm saying? See, me personally, I find people like Superman, Wonder Woman, Batman, the Power Rangers, the X-Men, who else? She-Ra, He-Man, Hulk, the Incredible Hulk, Aquaman. I find these people to be more inspiring to me. And I say that because this guy doesn't even show his face, won't even talk to you. You claim you're in a relationship with this guy. He won't even show up to be seen with you in public. He won't speak out loud, so we know this. You're in a relationship, okay? He does everything secretive and private, but he always wants worship. He always wants praise. And then, when you don't give it to him, he gets in his feelings and threatens you with burning you forever in some fire. People like Superman, Spider-Man, Wonder Woman, superheroes. These heroes go around the world helping people, saving people, right? And they never ask to be worshiped or praised. Y'all ever think about that? Y'all ever think about that? They go around the world popping up. People in trouble, they pop up. And they help people. They fight crime. They trying to help humanity, right? But I've never seen one cartoon, one episode of a show of anything where any of them asked to be worshiped or praised. I find them more inspiring than this God and this Jesus. They never threatened. They never threw it back in anybody's face when they help you. They never threw it back in your face that they helped you and threatened you. If you don't worship me, because I did this for you. I did that. I saved you. And if you don't worship me, I'm going to get jealous and I'm going to send you to burn with Devil Man down there. Devil Man's going to burn you, which is really just my alter ego. It's just how I break shit down in my head. That's why I don't believe this shit. It's just all a grown-up fairy tale. Just like these cartoons. It looked like it brought me back on. But what I'm saying is this. None of these characters ever ask to be praised or worshipped. They just do what they do in humanity. And then, if the devil is the guy punishing evil people, tell me why is the devil such a bad person? Or such a bad character. I rock with the devil for that. Because it seems to me like the devil is doing what God should be doing. You tell me God is with us all the time. He's always, he's everywhere. He's there, he's here, he's there. He's over there before you even get there. He was right there when they were creating, when they were just talking about fucking us up with that coronavirus. He was right there when they decided we're going to create slavery. He was there with the slaves while they were getting whipped and beat. This is just according to y'all logic. This is according to you guys' logic. I don't believe in a God or a devil. I believe there's good, there's bad. There's good, there's evil. You either are or you're not. How I break shit down in my head. I think I'm going to continue the breakdown show. I'm going to just try to cut the time down from here on out, but I kind of like the breakdown show because I never really get a chance to take people into my mind on how I break shit down and why I cannot believe this bullshit. And I try to figure out why do you, as a grown adult, on purpose, trick your own self to believe this shit with no evidence. See, I'm not going in the book, right? I'm not pulling out Bible verses. You didn't hear me pull out no Bible verses. You might have heard me reference a couple here and there, but you didn't hear me going into no Bible verses. I'm dealing with the claims you guys bring to us, the claims you guys have been making forever about your God. And then I bring my mind into this to break your claims down. I'm challenging the claims you make to see if I want to believe them or not. It's like a math problem. Shit's not fucking adding up. It's more than one number that's off. It's more than one number. Tonight, 11 p.m., Sin City Untamed page. Go to that page. Like that page. I'm not sure how much I'll get to go in tonight. I will be on the show, but I won't be able to let loose like this. So if you have any pastors, any bishops, any believers who want to come on and talk to me, I welcome any of them. I welcome any of them. Send your pastors, send your prophets, send your bishops. I will be respectful. As long as the energy comes respectful to me, I will bring the energy back respectful. There are people who can vouch for this. I don't just go off the deep end like this for no reason. It's usually when the energy is brought to me in a certain way. That's when they get the aggressive energy back out of me. I'm just a passionate speaker. I'm passionate when I talk. You got to help me understand. Listen, you're free to believe anything you want. It's just curiosity to me why a grown person would purposely, mentally trick themselves to lie for some god or gods that they can't even prove exists. They walk and live in fear every day of an imaginary adult boogeyman called the devil that they've never seen in their life. They're scared about going to some place called a hell that they don't know nobody that's ever been to a hell in their life. Came back to speak about it. How do you fucking know a hell exists? You talk about a heaven. Who's been to fucking heaven that you know? That you can, I know what you believe. See, I have to make believers get to a point to understand. You're not talking to me from a factual standpoint. Everything you say to me about a God, a religion, a Bible, a religious literature is coming from a belief standpoint, not factual. That's why I'm able to stand on and be so cocky the way I say things and the way I bring my question into you. Because nobody has proved religion to be factual at all. It's a belief. Look it up. Look it up. It's a belief. Religion, the Bible, sits in nobody's reference section. You will not see a Bible sitting next to any encyclopedia, thesaurus, dictionary, none of that shit. No history books. You will not see a Bible sitting in that section. It's going to be in a religious section or a nonfiction section. Or whatever, the fairy tale section. This is the breakdown. I think I'm going to continue to do this. I'm about to get out of here, y'all. Sorry the laugh took so long, but I really want to start cranking up, showing y'all, taking y'all into my videos and stuff. And another thing I'm going to start doing, I'm going to actually start hitting the streets with the camera. And I'm going to start challenging believers on site. Hey, tell me, what does the blood of Jesus mean? What is the blood of Jesus? What does it do? I'm going to start questioning believers on the spot. What does it mean? No weapons formed against me shall prosper. What are the weapons? What would they be? It wouldn't be the coronavirus. It wouldn't be slavery. It wouldn't be racism. It wouldn't be police brutality. It wouldn't be none of that. You see what I'm saying? You got to start making this make sense to me if you're going to push it and force it down our children's throats. That's my biggest issue.
You're forcing it down our children's throats. Hey, Pastor, do you really think a donkey talk? Hey, Pastor, which parts of the Bible do we take literally or we don't take literally? Which ones? Which parts? Now, which parts will be taken out of context? Is it just the ones that we challenge y'all on? You see what I'm saying? These are questions that I ask in my breakdowns. When was the last time you seen a burning bush talk, Pastor? When was the last time you seen a nigga moonwalk on water, Pastor? Hmm? Two loaves of bread, five fish, two loaves of bread, however that go. 5,000 some people, for real? How that ain't magic? That ain't magic tricks? No? That ain't some, drink what blood? What blood? Huh? We gonna drink some blood? You want me to bow my head and pray and summon a Holy Ghost? That don't sound like some, that shit don't sound weird. That don't sound like some witchcraft shit, like that y'all say is wrong, is evil, and that it don't sound like none of that. Breakdown. I think I'm gonna start doing this. I'm out of here, y'all. Truth speaks, free your mind. Free your mind, truth speaks. Tonight, 11 p.m., Sin City Untamed page. I know it's, go like that page on Facebook. I know it'll be streaming on there. And I think that's her YouTube page too, I believe. Let's talk about it tonight, 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'm out, y'all.